Good morning, my dear students. I am going to start the second module today, and the previous class I solved some problems related to one-dimensional heat conduction and also temperature distribution equation for slab and cylinder and composite cylinder. And because of time limitation, we could not able to solve more problems. And student may ask questions. We try to solve at least a minimum 2-3 question papers before going to examination. And if you have any doubt, the expert lecturers are there at your college. And your college, you can also talk to them. If not, I am leaving my milieu here. You can send a question which is not able to solve. I'll solve and send it back to you. So my email ID, I already noted down there. And another email ID is also there. You can also log into my principal login ID.
Principal. @RG. rgit.ac.in. You can also send your queries to this principal@rgit.ac.in,
and also I can note on that draman72@gmail.com. So this is for information. Any queries, any question papers, you have any doubts regarding any of the module is concerned, right from first module to fifth module, you can also communicate to me. I'm able to give you the solution for that. Okay, any exam problem, if you are not able to get the solution for that, you can also send the module 2. This is the 9th class I am going to take. The first topic of interest that I am going to discuss is filled surfaces or extended surfaces. You know, the page number in a data handbook, page number 50, Kodandraman and Subramanian, page number 50 is the various types of fin with the boundary conditions or solutions are given there. The equations, final equations are given there. One is the type of fins: long fin, short fin, short fin with the end insulated, short fin end is not insulated, and a specified end temperature. These are the condition that we have to solve the temperature distribution as well as heat flow equations. You know, any condition for heat transfer is, one is temperature distribution, another one is heat transfer. Only the two conditions. Why temperature distribution is required is to know how the heat is flowing from one direction to another direction. That is most important. And also from this temperature distribution, you can also find the temperature at various boundaries. Substituting these temperatures in a heat flow equation, in Fourier's law of thermal conduction equation, you will get the heat flow or rate of heat flow. If it is only the heat flow, then it is in watts. Rate of heat flow, heat flux also you can calculate watts per meter square. Rate of heat flow, it means if it is a unsteady state, you can also find out the rate of heat flow. Okay, then the fin surface or extended surface, you know that heat is conducted through body frequently and removed and delivered to the surrounding by convection process. It means the first heat is getting conducted by conduction, and it is convected to air and it is delivered to the surrounding. For example, the heat lost by conduction through furnace wall must be dissipated to the surrounding through convection. This is one of the example. Any wall which is getting heated up, how it is getting cooled? It is by losing heat to the air by convection. Is it not? Any object, if you take a iron rod and expose this iron rod, one end of the iron rod you holding your hand and another end is exposing to a flame, there it is gaining heat because you are exposing that to a very high temperature. So then it gains heat and you may experience some hotness in your body or by touching the finger at the other end. So again, it is placed in the atmosphere. After a certain period, the iron rod is getting cooled. It is because of what? It is because of the heat is getting dissipated through convection to the surrounding. So this is the process happening in any system and surrounding every time in the nature. Okay, and all the time in the nature, not every time, all the time in the nature, heating and cooling process is a continuous process, and all the system are exposed to the sun, they get heat and then get dissipated. That is how the system run. It means nature runs. The heat exchange application, the fin tubes arrangement might be used to remove the heat from the hot liquid. It means fin tubes are used when the large amount of heat accumulated in the liquid, you want only the specific temperature liquid, then you have to remove the excess amount of heat to the surrounding. That is one condition. That is by material, by finally dissipated to the surrounding by convection. So the obviously the analysis of combined conduction and convection system is very important for practical point of view. We are discussing that. It means conduction first takes place and then it goes to the surrounding by convection. Heat transfer convection between the surface and the fluid surrounding, it can be increased by attaching the extended surface or fin surface or thin strip of material is attached to the surface, then it is called as extended surface. I read the figure 1 and then I'll show you how the extended surface is going to. Large variety of fin geometries are available in nature. It means the manufactured are available in nature also. And figure 5 and 6, 3.5 and 6 shows the physical appearance of the typical geometry used in practical application. When heat transfer takes place by convection from both interior and exterior surface of the tube or plate, generally fins are used on surface where the heat transfer coefficient is very low. This is one of the most important discussion. You have to understand that the heat transfer coefficient is very low. So look at here. It means when the two, sorry, this surface. So this is what I want. The heat transfer coefficient is very low. Look at this. So the when it happens, when the case it happens is the water has got very high heat transfer coefficient, whereas the air is having very low heat transfer coefficient. Then you want to have the more area because the rate of heat flow is all depends on HA delta T. It means Q is directly proportional to the area. It means what? The area is more, the heat rate is also more. That is the meaning in this chapter. Area is more, directly proportional to the area. Area increases, heat flow increases. What the constant of proportionality you have to put here is, if you are equating, it is HA, H is the constant of proportionality, the heat transfer coefficient that you are putting into delta T. It means to low heat transfer coefficient, no, it doesn't matter. When the low heat transfer coefficient is there, still if you are increasing the area of exposed, area exposed from system to the surrounding, how the heat is transferred. So compensate this. To increase the enhance the heat transfer rate, you will have to add more area. How do you increase this more area? Suppose this is the wall, okay, and it is having very low heat transfer coefficient, very low heat transfer coefficient, and it is having temperature T infinity. Outside temperature is T infinity, and this is having a wall temperature. Okay, there are two different temperatures we are talking about. This is having a wall temperature, and this is T infinity. T infinity is air. Okay, then what you have to do, to how do you enhance the heat transfer rate? Only by providing a thin strip like this, extended surface. You can make extended surface like this. It means calculate the area, surface area exposed into the atmosphere where the area increases, the heat start dissipating more because of air has got very low heat transfer coefficient. That is one of the most important. For example, the car radiator, you must have seen outside surface of the tube is coated with a small thin finned surface. It means small thin sheet is attached to the copper tube in the heat exchanger.
So that I am going to write how the heat exchanger is going to be. So suppose the heat exchanger is like this. It is having a copper tube and it is encapsulated in a cabinet. So this is inlet, this is inlet, and this is outlet. Okay, this is in, this is out. Only this copper tube is insufficient to transfer heat from copper tube to the air, because in copper tube, inside copper tube, water is flowing or coolant is flowing, which is getting heat from the engine, and then it is cooled. Otherwise, engine never perform to the required efficiency. For that, what you have to continuously have to remove the heat, and you are putting one fan here also. So the fan is placed here. The fan is rotating. Okay. For what we do, we'll attach a fin like this all along the tube. What happens? Though the air is having very low heat transfer coefficient, because of the increasing surface, the almost heat dissipated from how much water is gaining heat from the engine with a high heat transfer coefficient, and same heat is getting dissipated because increasing the surface area of the fin, and this act as a radiator and that keep cooling the engine. This is what the surface is much smaller than the water flow. That is what you get. For example, car radiator is outer surface of the tube is fin because of heat transfer coefficient of air at the outer surface is much smaller than that of water flow at the inner surface. So the problem of determination of heat flow through the fin requires a knowledge of temperature. What it requires at temperature? Temperature knowledge is required, then you can calculate the heat flow. How the temperature knowledge is very much necessary for understanding this. What are the cases that? See, what are the type of fins that you are experiencing in practical application? So that is the AB or the extended surface having a straight uniform cross section, and thickness is also uniform. And C and D are the straight fin having non-uniform cross section. It means their cross section is not uniform. So there are two cases. One is rectangular fin, another one is a triangular fin, another one is a parabolic shape, that is a convex, it is a concave, sometimes also you get convex, sometimes concave. It means it is a type of geometry that you are using. This contour I am talking about. This contour is like a convex, and both the side if you appear, it may be convex and bulging on both sides, that can be used. This is the extended surface that you are going to use on the in the practical application for extended surface. Coming to the next type of fins that you are talking about, this is the spine, S-P-I-N, or constant cross-sectional area. Small pins are projected on the surface called a spine. So you must have seen integrated circuits or ICs are having a copper projected surface, because IC integrated circuit are generating lot of heat. If this heat is not dissipated to the surrounding, then the IC will not perform. Integrated circuit chip is there, that will not perform. That is why in central processing unit you are having a projection. Though it is having a projection, you are putting a small fan over there in order to suck the heat out of the, that is a type of fins that you are going to provide. Small fin spines you are providing on that. So this is one of the topic of research in almost all electronic industries. So the F and G are the spine of non-uniform cross section. Look at here, this is uniform cross section, this is uniform cross section, these two are the non-uniform cross sections. And cross H and I are the annulus ring, annulus fins
which is having a uniform cross section. This is having uniform cross section, and this is having, H is having uniform, I is having non-uniform cross section. These are the type of fins you are come across in practical application. So heat transfer through a rectangular fin. Consider one-dimensional fin exposed to the surrounding fluid at temperature T infinity, as shown in figure 3.7. The temperature of the base of the fin is always maintained at T0. Sometimes in the data handbook, he has given TB. TB is equal to T0. T base, TB means T base only. T0 means the at the base temperature. We approach the problem by making energy balance on an element of a fin of thickness dx, as shown in figure 3.8. So the figure shows the temperature distribution curve and fin having length L. Thus, the energy in the left phase is equal to the energy out in the right phase plus energy by convection, energy lost by convection. This is what we have. So this is the energy balance equation writing for this. This is a spine and this is a rectangular fin. And you know, all the nomenclatures that I have given with the equation is Q is equal to HA TW minus or T infinity or T0 minus T infinity. T0 is the base and T infinity is the air temperature, which is at the tip of the fin or surrounding the fin is T infinity. Look at here, T0 is at the base and T infinity at the surrounding fin. It means air temperature. This is pi D. Periphery is pi D. Temperature T at any point in the fin you can calculate. This is the cross-sectional area, diameter D, and area, cross-sectional area is pi D squared by 4. Here it is, cross-sectional area is L into thickness. This is the, that is base into thickness is the cross-sectional area. So first you have to understand the geometry. And what are the required geometry that you are going to write? How you are going to apply this to, by using boundary condition, how you are going to solve the problem. And to the derivation required for, okay, the extended surface uniform cross section I am considering, fin with a rectangle and fin with a circular profile. Two profiles I have taken, both are valid. You can write anyone in the examination, it can be applicable. Okay, see, suppose the heat is conducted in qx direction, elemental area dx is taken and it is conducted out qx plus dx. And you know that heat dissipation to the convection is H into area. Area is perimeter into dx, this elemental area. Perimeter into dx is the area. T minus T infinity. T is the temperature of this element. T minus T infinity. At that I have taken. Okay. So the length of the fin projected from the body, from the surface is L. And its dimensions are B into T. Into length, that is the volume. Okay, I am interested not in the volume, I am interested in cross sectional area. So go to the next. I explained sufficiently for this. What is this 3R mark indicates? 3R mark indicates that convective heat transfer coefficient at a temperature T infinity. This is what, can you see this? Okay, now I'll go to the, this is the temperature profile right from the base. It means come back. How the temperature distribution is there in this, all along the length of the tube. That is on xy coordinate I have plotted. So this is the base temperature. Base temperature is very high. As it goes along the length of the tube, length of the fin I am talking about, L is the length of the tube. Qx plus dx. And this is the temperature distribution. Means it's keep on decreasing. Temperature is keep on decreasing. Look at the arrow mark, temperature profile. Okay, this is how the temperature going to reduce. Heat transfer through a fin of uniform cross section, and this is the uniform cross section fin, and this is the base. It means TB is here at wall temperature T0, and the temperature distribution is temperature keep on increasing till it becomes the atmospheric temperature. So T infinity. Okay, this is the normal temperature. This is how you have to read this graph. See, the analysis of heat transfer from the fin surface made with following assumptions. The thickness of the fin is small compared with the length of the and width of the fin. It means thickness is considered to be negligibly small. It means we are considering, but still it is very small. Temperature gradient over the cross section are neglected. It means gradient over the cross sections are neglected at the ends, and the heat conduction treated as one dimensional. You should not take it as a three dimensional. It's only one dimensional heat conduction for any fin you have to calculate. This is one assumption. Homogeneous and isotropic fin material and thermal conductivity K of the fin material is constant. It means conductivity remains constant and the material should be homogeneous. This is the second assumption. No heat generation within the fin itself is considered. It is not considered. There is no heat generation because the fin is attached to the surface to dissipate heat from base to the surrounding or from the wall to the surrounding. Then there is no question of heat generation. If it is heat generating, again it start conducting back to the system. It means this assist the heat to transfer from system to the surrounding. System is the furnace wall, surrounding means atmosphere. A joint between the fin and the heated wall offers no bond resistance. It means if the fin is attached to the wall, so there is a welding or bonding or fixing or gluing, whatever you do, and it offers no resistance for the flow of heat. That is an assumption. Offers no bond resistance. Temperature at the root or base of the fin is uniform and equal to T0. T0 is equal to T base, TB. And temperature T0. Okay? These are the assumptions made. And after that, we are going to neglect the radiation exchange with the surrounding radiation effect, if any, are considered as included in the convective coefficient. It means if the radiation exchange takes place also, that is taken as convection coefficient, that is in the air. The heat balance equation already I told you, energy from the left phase, here it is the left phase, K dT by dx, T is missing there, okay, is equal to minus Ka dT by dx, energy conducted out from the right phase, here it is going, into Qx plus dx, that Qx plus dx value are written, and also the energy lost by convection, HPdx means perimeter into dx gives the cross-sectional area or the surface area. What direction heat dissipating? It is by the surface only, not by the end. It is by surface. It goes by surface. That is why the surface area exposed normal to the direction of heat is taken as perimeter into dx for an elemental area here like this. Okay? That's what the figure model I created. In that model, it is very well explained. So the T is missing here, you have to add a T here, dT by dx, okay. And it is noted that differential surface area for convection is the product of perimeter of the fin and the differential length dx. When we combine the quantity, the energy balance equation yields, which yields d square T by dx square plus HPKA T minus T infinity is equal to 0. This is again a Poisson's equation.
From the above equation, it is derived.
Okay, simplified from the above equation. So, energy conducted from the left phase is equal to the energy in the right phase. This is the energy in the right phase. Right from this point till this point, energy in the right phase. This is energy in the left phase is equal to energy in the right phase, this is the right phase, plus energy lost by convection. This is the energy lost by the convection. There are three quantities. If you simplify this, this quantity and this quantity is get cancelled. This flow is this quantity is get cancelled with this quantity, I'm sorry, this quantity, and only these two quantities are left out. That is d square t by dx square minus of ka into dx. dx is get cancelled. You will get hp here, k only left out. That is simplified further. You will get d square by dx square plus of hp by ka t minus t infinity is equal to 0. And put theta is equal to t minus t infinity. What is that theta is called? Theta is the representation of temperature difference at the surface. At any surface, at any point of surface is theta. So t I have taken, please note, I have not taken t b or t 0 or t base or t infinity. T is at any point. So this t is at any point in the fin. How do you write a fin? Fin is like this. Okay. So at this point, the temperature T I have taken. This is the temperature T. Okay. This is TB and this is, at this point, it is T infinity. At the end, T infinity, at the base, TB. And this is the temperature at anywhere in the fin surface. Okay. So now, and this is the theta. So this, assuming that m square is equal to, I am putting this m square is equal to hp by ka. Put here m square and d square minus m square theta is equal to theta. This has got two roots. That is d square minus m square is equal to 0. Therefore, d has got two roots plus or minus m. Plus or minus m. M value is hp by, m value is square root of hp by ka. So m value is again, I can write this as square root of, it's very difficult to write, and on it's very difficult to write using this tool. Anyhow, you can remember that next slide I am going to show that. M is equal to, here I am writing on the board, M is equal to square root of hp by ka. M square is equal to hp by ka, or M is equal to square root of, it has got two root, plus m minus m. You are taking not the minus value, I am taking the positive root of this above equation. So the solution for this differential equation, I am straight away taking the solution for differential equation. Already you have studied differential equation, how you get the solution for this, theta is equal to a e to the power of minus x plus b e to the power of plus x. This is the solution for the above equation, theta. Theta is equal to a e to the power of minus mx plus b e to the power of plus mx. This is the solution for the second order differential equation. There, having two roots, I am taking that root and solution for that differential equation. You can also approach mathematics teacher for getting this solution, how you are going to get it. Already you solved and then you understood, but it's it takes another 10 minutes to derive and finally get it. Finally, I have taken the solution for that equation. Say, what is e to the power of mx? E to the power of mx is equal to hyperbolic cos mx, hyperbolic sin mx is equal to e. That is the derivation I have done. There are two ways of solving this problem. You can also go for the first solution, and I can also use the hyperbolic sin and cos. I am going to solve this problem. Okay. So, therefore, substituting these two values in the equation 3.9. What values? E to the power of mx and e to the power of minus mx into the equation 3.9. So this value I am substituting directly. So a into e to the power of minus mx means this cos hyperbolic mx minus sin hyperbolic mx I have substituted here. Plus of b times cos hyperbolic mx minus b sin mx. Okay, here it is.
minus and plus are written.
Okay. Minus value is this, and this plus value. Say sign difference is there. This is supposed to be minus only, and the solution for this you will get a plus b of cos hyperbolic mx plus a minus sin mx. There is a sign difference. Okay, so a plus b is equal to c. Put again the constant, a plus b is equal to c, a minus b is equal to c1 and c2. So here a plus b is equal to c1, a minus b is equal to c2. I am putting, finally you will get the boundary condition equation 3.9. theta is equal to, it means temperature distance, temperature difference between the known point and the unknown point is theta, c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. This is the equation 3.10. is best I substituted this and converted this into some constant c1 and c2. How do you find out the constant c1 and c2? That you are going to take by considering the boundary condition. 3.10 equation I am going to write here. That is the standard equation that I am going to use. This is one condition. Another condition is theta is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. This equation. There are two equations here. One is 3.10, another one is 3.9, and this is 3.10. There is a sign mistake is there, that you have to, I have to correct it. And you are substituting these two values in this, a into e to the power of this minus, and this become plus here. So after taking the first boundary condition that I want to study, what are the different boundary conditions that are prevailing practically? See, there are different physical situation may be considered. One is heat dissipated from a infinite long length fin. Infinitely long fin means what? The fin is having a very long length compared to the surface. Then this is the extended surface. It means L become infinity. Length become infinity. Is it possible to have an extended surface with infinity? No, it's not possible. Sufficiently long. It means it is L is equal to infinity. Therefore, the temperature gradient at dT by dx is equal to 0 at dT by dx is equal to 0. There is no temperature gradient exists at that, it is become normal. The another condition is a fin with a convection at the tip. It means a fin having a sufficient length, but it is having a convective coefficient at dH. The third case is heat dissipated from the fin insulated at the tip. It means the fin is insulated. There is no the possibility of flow of heat from the fin. That is, fin is insulated here. Okay. Another is heat dissipation from the fin having a finite length or long fin. It means this is the case. Finite length and heat is dissipating this. There are four cases. One is infinite long, very long fin, infinitely long, and which is having a convection tip H, and is having insulation, and it is having a sufficient length L. These are the some of the physical boundary conditions that you are going to consider. And with the temperature boundary condition and convection boundary condition, I am going to solve this using this problem, using this basic solution. So the first boundary condition, fin is having a convection at the tip. So not convection at the tip. I'll go back and this I differently plotted. It's supposed to be here. The first boundary condition, that heat dissipation from the infinitely long fin. What is the figure that you are going to get? How the infinitely long fin that's going to be considered? See here the, this is not infinitely long. 1 minute of that figure I am going to show you. This is the infinitely long fin. So the infinitely long fin means you have to, L is equal to infinity. And I used that figure for this and this one for that. So infinite means there is a cross. This length is long, that is why it is shown here. The split of the figure at this point L is equal to infinity and temperature T is equal to T naught at x is equal to 0, temperature T is equal to T infinity at x is equal to T infinity. Okay, so this is the surrounding temperature is T when the L is sufficiently long length. Okay, go back to the same page, that is page number 15 I think. Okay, and this is the temperature distribution. Same condition I have taken here TB, and then but there should be a L is equal to L infinity in this case you have to use. So here L is equal to L infinity. You have to use L is equal to L infinity. You have to use here. This is what the difference. And you should have because there infinity means when you're writing, there should be a long, sufficiently long, and I cannot show that much long. That is why you have to split this into two parts and then show it. This is the convention in design that we are going to show it. Okay, this is the base and this is the tip and this is the surface area. Surrounding temperature is T infinity. So there are various values of M1, M2, M3. M1 is less than M1. M2 and M3. Okay, so this is the temperature distribution and this is the direction x, and how the temperature distribution varies for different materials. The M1 is having a different material, M2 is having a different material, M3 is having a different material, because M is equal to square root of HP by KA. H is the heat transfer coefficient, A is the area of cross section, or you maybe take peripheral area, and K means the conductivity of the material. So this all depends on the type of material. Temperature distribution keep on varying. That is why M1, M2, M3 are taken. So substituting the boundary condition. So where x is equal to 0 in this equation, if you take where x is equal to 0, what do you get? Using first boundary condition, theta is equal to theta naught and x is equal to 0. It means A plus B is equal to theta naught you are going to get, because anything above E for fx 0 is 1 and minus x is also 0. So 1. So therefore A plus B is equal to theta naught, because theta is equal to theta naught. If we substitute A e to the power of 0 plus B e to the power of 0, get x is equal to 0, then A plus B is equal to what? A plus B is equal to theta naught. So that's what I written. And using a second boundary condition, when theta is equal to 0 at x is equal to, because when theta is equal to 0, why it becomes 0? There is no temperature gradient exists if the fin is sufficiently very long fin. So it is having a very long fin, then the temperature at this point is 0, theta is equal to 0. So that case you have, what do you use? 0 is equal to A is equal to 0 and B is equal to theta naught you are going to get. This is the first condition. Using the boundary condition, theta is equal to 0 at x is equal to infinity. When you put these two conditions in the above equation, in this equation, theta is equal to 0, A e to the power of, x is equal to infinity you have to put, e to the power of minus m into infinity plus b e to the power of minus m into infinity. What do you get? So you will get A is equal to 0, B is equal to theta naught. Substituting back these two boundary condition into this equation. So what do you get? Therefore, theta is equal to theta naught. A is again A plus B is equal to theta naught is there. A is equal to 0. B is equal to theta naught. Substitute those two values in the above equation. What do you get? Theta by theta naught is equal to e to the power of minus mx. So this value is given in the data handbook, page number 50.
So where theta is equal to T minus T zero and T wall minus T infinity, T base minus T infinity or T infinity. So this is equal to E to power of minus mx.
This is there in the data handbook, the temperature distribution equation. So the next the topic of interest is to discuss the heat flow through a fin can be evaluated by Fourier's law of thermal conduction. So the Fourier's law of thermal conduction, from the expression of temperature distribution, this 3.1,
this is 3.11. From this also you can calculate the temperature distribution using the temperature distribution equation. You can also calculate the rate of heat flow.
So what is dT by dx is equal to?
So this equation, I want T minus T infinity divided by T B minus T infinity is equal to E to the power of minus mx. Cross multiply, we already get T is equal to T infinity plus of T B minus T infinity E to the power of minus mx. So you have to differentiate this equation dT by dx. What do you get? So if you differentiate that dT by dx is equal to,
with respect to x you have to differentiate, you will get minus m of
T0 TB minus T infinity E to the power of minus mx.
At x is equal to 0. So what do you get?
This is at x is equal to 0.
What do you get out of this? dT by dx is equal to dT by dx as at x is equal to 0, the limit, you will get minus m of TB minus T infinity. This become 1 and you only get this quantity at x is equal to 0. After putting the limit, you will get this quantity minus m T naught minus T infinity you get, or TB minus T infinity.
TB is nothing but T naught at the base temperature. So by substituting this in the heat conduction equation, that is Q fin is equal to minus Ka dT by dx at x is equal to 0. So what do you get? Minus K into A, m value is there, minus minus become plus m into T0 minus T infinity. This you are going to get. That is Q fin.
So from this m is equal to, substitute m is equal to square root of hb by ka. Substituting this equation, what you get? Q fin is equal to ka root of hb by ka root. So you can take one more root, multiply by one more root, you'll get cancel, you'll get one more root ka you get here. So from this, what you get? This is equal to, this is T0 minus T infinity. Finally, what you get? Square root of hp ka T0 minus T infinity is the answer. And this equation is given very well in the data handbook. That is page number 50, equation 3.2. So here it is TB minus T infinity square root of hp ka is given. In page number 50, you can take the first derivation, first condition that I derived this. Okay.
All the students need to practice this derivation. This is not that difficult to understand, but only thing is this derivation, they are going to ask for 8 marks or 10 marks. It is compulsory.
There one or the other derivation is going to be asked. You can also understand this. Second case I am going to take it. When the fin is having convective boundary condition at the tip, convection at the tip, that is second case, physical situation. So using boundary condition T is equal to T0 at x is equal to 0.
So that I am going to write the fin. This is the fin, and it is h is equal to, sorry, this is conductivity k, and t is equal to t0, and t is equal to t infinity. Two boundary conditions I have taken. So the at x is equal to 0, it means x is equal to 0 means at this point. Okay, in terms of theta, so in terms of theta, I write t minus t0. This is equal to theta. T0 minus T infinity. Another boundary condition, that is equal to theta naught. Theta is equal to theta naught. Or else, how do you remember this? I written T is equal to T naught here. Substitute T is equal to minus T infinity in this equation. Is equal to T naught minus T infinity in this equation. Only a minus I am putting in terms of theta to express T minus T is equal to T theta. It means base temperature at x is equal to 0. This is the first boundary condition. They were to take boundary condition T is equal to T naught minus T infinity put on both sides. So in terms of theta, you have to express this is theta is equal to theta naught. Because 0 is there, you can put it. So this condition is, what is the condition? It is at x is equal to L. This is at this point. And this is at this point. It means the temperature at the base. This is at the base, this is at the tip. Therefore, theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to L. And it is having convective boundary condition. Convection means there is a convection current is going, that is H is flowing there. At what temperature? At temperature T infinity. This is one extended surface and this is the boundary condition. So again, by using the, so here I taken T is equal to T naught and T is equal to T infinity at x is equal to L, and this is the convection boundary condition, this is the cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area is at the tip. This is AC, A suffix C means cross-sectional area, and this is the base of the fin. Base of the fin attached to the wall, and this is the extended surface. Okay, any more details you can also take there. This is considering the second boundary condition at the tip with the area, with the cross sectional area. So, heat is conducted out from the this only, not from the surrounding. Only from the tip, heat is conducted. QL is conducted at x is equal to L. What is that? QL is equal to QL convection. This is conduction. QL conduction is equal to QL convection. This is conduction, this is convection. How do you write that? QL is equal to minus KAC minus K cross sectional area exposed normal to the direction of heat flow. The area exposed normal to the direction of heat flow is cross sectional area. Right? That I am taking that AC. So instead of dt by dx, I will take d theta by dx. Theta is the temperature difference. Theta t minus t infinity is the temperature difference. Theta. Okay? At x is equal to L, this is equal to, it means at this point I am considering the second boundary condition. First boundary condition already taken here. Second boundary condition I am going to consider it here. What is that? Area exposed to the atmosphere is cross-sectional area into convection heat transfer coefficient into the temperature difference is theta at x is equal to L. This is second boundary condition. So using the first boundary condition, you substitute in the equation 3.10. What is that equation 3.10? Theta is equal to C1 cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sine hyperbolic mx. This is 3.10. This is the
equation that I am going to use to solve the boundary conditions. This is the general equation, general equation for that. I think the reflection is there. You can see now clearly. Can you see it now clearly? There is no reflection as such. So this equation I am going to use. By using this equation,
one minute, I am not able to, myself I am not able to visualize.
Okay. Substitute the first boundary condition in this equation. What is the first boundary condition? Theta is equal to t is equal to t naught at x is equal to L. If using the first boundary condition and second boundary condition, I am going to solve. C1 is equal to theta naught. Because x is equal to 0 means what you get? X is equal to 0 means this become 1, this become completely 0. This quantity becomes 0, this quantity become 1. So therefore theta naught, theta is equal to theta naught is equal to C1 only get from this equation. Can you see this? See, sine hyperbolic 0 is 0. Sine cos hyperbolic x is 0. Cos hyperbolic 0 is 1. Therefore, C1 is equal to theta naught. What shall I write for that equation? Theta is equal to theta naught cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. This is not the equation you are going to get. So this can be solved. C2 can be solved by using second boundary condition. What is that second boundary condition? So you have to differentiate this equation with respect to x again. And what do you get? Differentiating this d theta by dx is equal to differentiation of the this cos hyperbolic mx, x value is there, that with constant theta naught, and what do you get? Sin hyperbolic mx into m, you get plus c2 m into, because differentiation of this is cos hyperbolic mx, you get. I am differentiating the same equation. What after finding the first boundary condition, substituting in this, and then getting the equation like this. And then I am differentiating that equation, substituting back this in the this equation, this into the second boundary condition. Here I have to say d theta by dx, d theta by dx is equal to this quantity, you have to substitute here, and theta is equal to theta naught, theta is equal to this, you have to substitute here. Are you following? The two equations are there, theta is equal to d theta by dx. I want the second boundary condition to be satisfied. For that, I am using these two equations and substituting theta is equal to here, d theta by dx here, at x is equal to L. And you have to modify x is equal to L there. The time is up now. I am going to take up in the next class. Time is up now. I'll continue in the next class, but I go little slow because to make you understand is difficult.